Hey there, Arlen from Vitality and Performance, and today I want to take you through walking lunges. With walking lunges, it's one of the most compound leg exercises available, but you need to take the steps literally to do it properly. Now, one of the things that I like to focus on, as with all exercises, is breathing and bracing properly, like you'll see in different videos as well. Breathing down to the stomach, bracing before impact. Impact can mean applying power, so to move or to slam on the brakes. Right, a couple of things that you want to think of with walking lunges is the stride length. The smaller you make your stride length, the more you're working on the quadriceps, less on the glutes, especially in the walking variation. So doing this and this, you don't have the hyperextension in the glutes and the hips. So if you want to have proper glute development to get involved here, if you want to have a proper stride length, a good indication would be to have both knees in 90 degrees. Notice that I have my back foot on the toes, foot upright. Then, foot width. So you've got a rope lying over here. A lot of people tend to have their feet in line with each other. This, as you can see, is not very useful for my balance. So if you go a little bit wider, you've got a better base. So what you want to visualize is a rope or a line of bricks or a thick white line, those marking lines, that's lying there to use as an indicator for your foot width. Nice big step. That way you can be sure that you are not putting your feet too narrow and losing balance. The balance walking lunge is a different variation, but for now, this is the proper basic. Then we also want to look at foot position. With foot position, you want to have the front foot toes slightly turned inwards, not too far, definitely not straight or out. Having the toes slightly inward gives you a lot more balance as well. For a better balance, you want to think of a foot with 3 points. And with the toes slightly inwards, you actually have the heel toes and back foot toes. So to give you an example, so for extra stability, so you don't get distracted by your balance, that's more focused on your movement, your breathing, your bracing, and your applying power and the speed. Right, then you also want to look at body position. This is dependent on your personal goal and how far you've come, how strong your back is. You can think, for instance, if your back is not that strong and you're a beginner to intermediate with walking lunges, you can think of having the upper body in a straight position. Notice that I'll have the arms opposite, so if the left foot is forward, the right arm is forward, just as we walk. Having a specific sport as a goal, you can think of actually leaning into it. Because with rugby, for instance, or with hockey or other sports, you're actually going to go forward in the position, and then it's fine to have the upper body leaning into it because the body wants to get used to it, get stronger in that position. So that's fine. So it's really dependent on your goal. So the examples here would be going forward every single time. Then you can also add weights, and also this makes a difference of your goal and capabilities. So with this, I'm using two hands, two weights. Big steps, but it's also fine. This is a farmer's walk variation, but you can also do anti-leaning variation, extra plank, weight on one side. And if you're a little bit stronger, you can have the weights on the shoulders. You can even do an overhead carry variation with this. Now, a couple of extra examples of lunges. If you want to build up, and I'll explain. explain this in a different video in more, a lot more detail, but you have the static lunge, step forward lunge, step back, the walking lunge, normal as I've just done, but you can also do a little bit more glute extra rotation, wide lunges, and you can also do jumping lunges or jumping switch lunges. And that's it, all in short, a couple of great leg variation, lunge variations. Remember though, breathing and bracing, so from this position before you land, you want to be in the brace, so that's an upright position, the highest position. Keep it on, and then in your hover movement, you breathe, brace again. And that way, your brace is stronger, which means you've got an efficient power to ground force and safer movement, less risk of injuries. Yeah? That's it in short. Try it out. Questions, let me know. So the walking lunges, example, front, big steps. Remember with the big steps, I get the glute. That's it.